So now we have done the FS settings. Now we will be continue our CO settings for SAP S/4HANA Simple Finance. Okay. So first we need to define the controlling area, which is the controlling area. Now we are doing the controlling area configuration. Maintain controlling area. We'll define our controlling area. If you are going to use the one controlling area for many company code, then you need to use the cross company code, cost accounting. So if it is a one controlling area, one company code, then you need to use the one step. Now you can use the cross company code, cost accounting. Okay, because this chart of account, this controlling area we can use for multiple company codes. So we are going to use as a group currency. So we need to define the valuation profile also, because the valuation profile, the currency and valuation profile is required for the material ledger. If you want to see the any material, so if you activate this valuation profile, then we can see the one material in multiple currency, its valuation, how much the valuation, everything. Okay, then we need to define chart of account. If you want to use the one controlling area and multiple company codes, the chart of account, fiscal year variant and posting period variance, everything should be, these three parameters should be the same. Then only 1:2 we can do it. So now we are going to create the standard hierarchy also. So I have done creation of the maintain controlling area. Now we will be activate the certain components, how we have in FICO APAR asset accounting. In the same way, in controlling area we have the cost center accounting, profit center accounting, commitment and profitability analysis, so many we have. So we need to activate which are the components we are required as per the business. this then just misses. We need to activate the disk layer. So activity accounting. So the cost center accounting and order, internal order we need to activate. Then commitment management, the profitability will not be get activated because if you are going to run the operating concern then automatically it will get activate. The cost objective, sales order, projects and commitment and all variance. Then just warning message, we can ignore this one. We can go ahead and assign the number range for controlling area. So all the plan is one number range and actual is one number range and FI related one number range we can define here. So three type of number range. So the every transaction type we need to assign the member name, so that we will not see any error for that while you are posting the CO postings. So all we need to assign. So the number in this account that the business requirement you can define, or for as I told you for each actuals and the plans you can define the each one number range as separately, okay. So that you will come to know the range which is belongs to that, is it actuals or so. Time being, just I'm saving. I have given only very less. Now we are going to create the hierarchy. Before that, we should do the versions. Maintain a version. So the version 0, it will be store the actual as well as plan. So apart from that, the other the versions will be it will be store only the plan values only. Why? Because the version 0 is storing the actual value. Already we are having the actual value. See, last year we have given the some value, plan value. In the same way, it's storing into the, it is going to be changing the plan value, but actual value will not be changed. So whatever the actual postings will be there, that will be get stored in the version 0. So that is the reason only it will, we will be, apart from that 0 version, we will be request only the plan value. No actual value will not request. It will be stored, but we will not request. Now I need to define, it is going to store the valuation. So how many valuations we have? Legal valuation and the group valuation, profit center valuation we have. Then fiscal year we need to define. Now copy, integrate. So for controlling area we have the exchange rate type called P. So even you can use the exchange rate type M also. So always the versions will be created for 5 years. you click here, so this is the exchange rate is going to be create plan. We need to define here. Then coming to so the last thing. Okay, it is complicated. Just stop. Basic settings, automation, conversions. In SAP S/4HANA, we need to define the sequence way. First, we need to do the basic settings of the FI and CO. Then only we need to go for ledger configuration. Otherwise, there is a inconsistency while we are going to posting. So suppose if you are doing FICO basic setting plus ledger, then you are not defining the basic steps of a CO. Then the postings will not be done in consistency. It will be shown as inconsistency for the postings. Okay. So I have done this one for 2 years. Okay. And these are the basic settings. Now I will be doing the standard hierarchy. I will do it. So under this, just we will define the plans for us also. So the hierarchy will be this then. Highest hierarchy. Under that, under this node, we need to define our nodes. client 1, under this in the same day one more book, client 2 IN05, so client 2 we can define here. So we need to define the cost centers on each plant for logistics and the production for everything. Now we have defined the standard hierarchy for this. So we need to define the profit center accounting also. So we can define profit center group. Then we need to elimination of the inter business volume. Okay, so the double entry it is going to be eliminating. Controlling the currency, we are going to give you this for legal valuation. Okay. Legal valuation, group valuation, profit center valuation. Now we are doing the legal valuation. First, we need to define the hierarchy in profit center accounting. results are not showing. This is assigned. Okay, now we will do it the assignment of company code. That is the reason we are showing that. No, we will not see the error. Now we will be defining the prof center component basic settings. If you don't activate this, if you don't click on this indicator, so you will not able to post the anything for this. If you activate, then only it will get a post. And we need to create the dummy profit center always for any company code, because if user is not giving the any profit center, the value will automatically will be go to the dummy profit center. So every monthly wise they need to check the dummy profit center should be zero value. If it is certain value is there, so which is the correct profit center, they need to distribute it. So we need to create a dummy profit center slash E59, or we can create as a 999. Dummy profit center. So let's assign. You post the any value if you don't give the this one. So these are the basic settings or completed for controlling area. The part 3 we can see the ledger configuration and the automatic default profit center, how it will be derived. Those we'll see in the part 3. Okay.